What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Chaotic Kicks, aka Mr. I Rock My Sneakers, and I'm back with another video for y'all, man. Listen, I am highly upset, man. The Adidas Yeezy Farm Runner shock dropped on Yeezy Supply the other day, and your boy actually had the shoe in the court, man. My personal size, bro, because I really would love to have given y'all a review on that, man, but for some reason, bro, I couldn't check out, man. Yeezy Supply did not let your boy check out, man. Whenever I got to the payment process, man, it refused to let me process my payment, man. So I end up taking an L, bro. So it is what it is, man. Y'all excuse the noise. I am at work. Got other vehicles, other trucks, man, around me, bro. So that's the noise y'all hearing in the background. But listen, man, to give my honest opinion about the sneaker, man, I ain't gonna lie to you. It's the look of it is out of this world, man. You know what I'm saying? It kind of remind me of something from the movie Tremors way back in the day, man. That's how ugly that sneaker looks. But I won't take away the fact that it might be a comfortable summer sneaker, man. You know what I'm saying? So that might be something that most people would like to have on their feet during the summertime. As you can see, I'll show a picture somewhere around here, man. You can see that it does have the air ventilation hose all on the sneaker, but it just looked crazy to me, man. You know what I'm saying? But nonetheless, I still probably would put it on toes just to feel the comfort level of the sneaker. Also, the Barons did also drop on the 25th. Your boy do have a review coming with those probably one day this week, man. I hit for the LeBron James MVP as well, and also, man, the Kamikaze Sean Kemp's, man, Reeboks. Your boy do have a pair of those all coming, man. So there's about to be a bunch of reviews coming, man. Y'all stay tuned to the channel. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, man, please go ahead and hit that notification bell. Hit that subscribe button. And also leave a like on the video as well, man. It helps YouTube to push out the video, man. But let's get back to this sneaker, man, or this thing. It kind of reminds me of a Croc too, man. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, if you rocking slides, Croc, or flip-flops during the summertime, man, I think that this would definitely be a dope pair for you to actually put on toes during the summer, man. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, man, this sneaker retailed at $75, man. And if you go on StockX or GOAT right now, the resale value on this thing is almost at $400, if it ain't already, man. Last time I checked, in my size, it was at $400, and I think that the bidding price was at like $370, $380, man. You know what I'm saying? And if I would have pulled the trigger when I first went on StockX, bro, for my size, right during the release, it was $150, man. Who thought that this sneaker would have a resale value like that, man? Ugly as that sneaker look, the resale is definitely doing good on it, man. So if you hit for a pair, man, congratulations. If you decided to sell, bro, definitely making one hell of a profit, man. This is the first Yeezy Farm Runner that we've seen, man. I'm kind of excited to see what other colorways they gonna come up with. Just like the 700 V3s, man, you seen that they did drop the bone colorway, and then they back though gave us the black, triple black Alvas, man. So I'm definitely excited to see what other colorways will be coming with this new style, new silhouette that they got, man. I'm pretty sure that they will hit us with a black one. I would really love to see like that earth tone colorway, man. Even like the sofa colorway or desert stage colorway, man. Just something like that, man. I think that would be dope if they started giving us different colors, man. That give people an option, man, on what to cop, man. But you always know every time they do that first, the first one is always the highest resale value when it comes to dropping the new silhouette, man. So with this white one, man, for it to be $75 and for it to have that type of high resale value, man, that is definitely a good look for it, man. And like I said, if you cop, man, congratulations, shout out to you, man. I don't know anybody personal that hit, but July 18th, we also do have the Yeezy 350 V2 Zions dropping, man. And that is definitely one of the sneakers that your boy is definitely trying to get in the collection as well, man. I love the colorway. It kind of remind me of the Turtle Doves, man, that dropped way back when. But your boy is definitely going to try to get that pair as well so I can bring y'all the review. But I'm not going to hold you guys up too long. I just wanted to rant with y'all just a little bit, man, about that Adidas Yeezy Farm Runner that Shock dropped on us the other day, June the 26th. And like I said, be looking forward to those reviews for the LeBron 7 MVPs, the Barium Adidas Quantums that just released on the 25th, and also the Kamikaze Reeboks, man, if y'all are into those type sneakers, especially Reeboks, you know what I'm saying? But y'all leave me a like, subscribe to the channel if you're not, ring that notification bell so you never miss a video whenever your boy uploads one, man. So until next time, man, it's your boy Chaotic Kicks, aka Mr. I Rock My Sneakers, man, and I'm gonna see you guys on another. Peace.